Hey peeps, what's up? Happy Wednesday! Welcome to Warrior Wednesday. It's Wednesday, February 6th. We are in Aquarius season. So if you're an Aquarius, say holla, because I'm also an Aquarius. My birthday was January 25th, beginning of Aquarius, and we are in Aquarius season, which I love Aquarians. So if you're an Aquarius, say holla, I'm an Aquarius. And if you're on here live, say what's up so I can acknowledge you. And if you're catching the replay, comment with hashtag replay so I can say hi and acknowledge you. All right. So if we haven't met yet, my name is Zena Solomon, and I'm here to support you in reinventing yourself so you can create a life by design versus living a life by default. And in the process, you get to connect with your vision, your values, your life purpose, passion, and also create possibility. And so today I'm going to be covering fear. So who here has fear? So if you're on here live, just like give me some hearts, give me some likes, and just give me some love so I know that you're on here, and just say hello so I can acknowledge you. So we all have fear, right? And my intention for today is to walk you through five simple strategies on how you can overcome fear. So with that said, as far as fear goes, I will share with you that in my experience, I had a lot of fear that came up for me in different areas of life. Hey, Murat, great to see you on here. Hi, what's up? All right, so as far as fear goes, fear comes up anytime you are in a space of stretching yourself and stepping into that higher purpose of yourself. Like anytime you're in a space of moving into that next level, whatever that next cut, whatever that next level looks like for you, then you will feel fear. You'll be like, oh my God, it's so uncomfortable. I don't know if I can do this. Like if you can relate, say I, so I can see you. And I mean, I'm sharing straight up how I feel, what comes up for me and what has also come up for a lot of my clients. So if you feel me, just say I feel you or something like that. So I know you get what I'm saying here. And so there are several ways that you can spot fear. And one of the first ways you can spot fear is if you feel resistance towards something. Oh, awesome. Awesome, Murat. Yeah, totally. Yeah, awesome. Yeah, so if you have a resistance towards something, that is a great indication that you have fear. Because anytime you are about to go outside of your comfort zone, resistance will come up. And that is a form of fear. Fear and resistance actually go hand in hand. And so there are several acronyms for fear that I'm sure you guys are pretty familiar with and you've heard. So like the first acronym for fear is false evidence appearing real, right? I mean, because of course fear is not real and it's all in our heads, like it's not even real, right? There are a couple of ones that I really, really like that are on the negative side and also on the positive side. So the other acronym for fear is finding excuses in reasons. So if you're in a space of having a specific goal or a dream and you're going towards that dream and you're finding yourself in a space of excuses and reasons why you can't do it, know that that's coming from fear. Okay, so that's another indication. The other indication is forget everything and run, which is another acronym for fear. So if you're in a space of hiding or avoiding being in relationship to what you want to create, so you're forgetting everything and you're just running away from it, that is a form of fear, okay? One of my favorite acronyms for fear, which is on the positive side, is face everything and rise, right? So face everything and rise. And so even though you feel the fear, you just face it and you just rise above it because you're more powerful than the fear itself. So I want to say something about fear real quick before I move into the five simple strategies. So the fear is an emotion, right? And we're emotional beings, and any emotion we have in our bodies or that we feel, typically the lifespan of an emotion, whether it's like anger, resistance, whatever that is, it's usually 90 seconds. Like really it's 90 seconds. That's the lifespan of any emotion. And so if you're experiencing fear, the invitation for you is to be with that feeling of fear and let feel it for 90 seconds, which is a minute and a half, really. It's not that long. And then you'll just find it dissipating afterwards, right? So that's with any emotion, by the way. So I would encourage you to try it out and see what opens up for you. Any emotion, like if you're angry or whatever, just be in that energy, like whatever that emotion is, for 90 seconds and see how it goes. See if you can stay with it or if it goes away after 90 seconds, okay? So as far as fear, different types of fear, real quick, is like for me, my biggest fear was fear of being judged, fear of being criticized, fear of failure, fear of not being good enough. Those are my fears. I have a lot of fears, by the way, just in case. If you guys haven't noticed, I do have a lot of fears. So, fear also of underachieving, overachieving, fear of looking bad or feeling foolish or looking foolish. Those are my fears too. Fear of death, huge. Fear of being lonely, huge as well. So the five strategies, so we all have those fears, right? And you can leverage those feelings and the fear or the emotion piece of it as fuel towards what you want to create instead of have it be debilitating. Because I remember many years ago, I used to be debilitated by my fear. If you can relate, just say I, or you know, say I feel you, I get it, right? I used to really be debilitated by fear. Like I would be paralyzed because I was just so in my head. You know what I'm saying? So what got me out of it was instead of using that energy to be locked in, I was like, okay, I'm going to use that to fuel what I want to create. And so, my indication, the first step really for you to overcome fear is to recognize it. So, when you recognize it and you're aware of it, then that's when you're going to overcome it because you're aware of it, right? And then the second step, I want you to really connect with what is it costing you to be in fear? Like, what are the prices that you're paying, and what are the things that you're not creating because you're stuck in fear? So I want you to really connect with that, because if you're not connected to that, then you're really like going to be in fear constantly. And fear will show up in moments. It'll show up all the time, just part of being human, right? So that's the second step. Third step is the 5 second rule, which Mel Robbins is, she wrote a book called The 5 second Rule. And the 5 second rule, basically what it is if you have fear of doing something, you do a countdown from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and you say go, and you just do it. You know, like Nike, just do it. You just do it. So the 5 second rule, if you haven't gotten her book, check it out. It's an amazing book. It's very simple. It's fun. I have the audio version. She's amazing. I love Mel Robbins. And so the 5 second rule, you count backwards, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and you just do it. So that's the third strategy. The fourth strategy is ask yourself, what are the steps for me to get to my vision? What are the steps for me to get to my goal? And just take one simple step towards it. Even one tiny step, because one tiny step will move the needle forward in the direction you want to go, and it'll prove to yourself that you can overcome fear because you took a simple step. But if you make it too big, then you're going to be in paralysis analysis and you're not going to do anything about it. You know what I'm saying? So that is the fourth strategy. Final strategy is I invite my clients to have an accomplishment journal. And the reason you want to do that is because at the end of every single day, you want to document the things that you accomplished. So you can say, oh my gosh, I had fear about this, but then I took this action and I created this result or whatever. And you are proud of yourself because you created an accomplishment, right? And so when you feel accomplished at the end of the day, at the end of the week, you can review all of your accomplishments and those small little wins. There are milestones that build up into bigger wins. So that is the final strategy for you to overcome fear. So the mission for you for this week is that I invite you actually to share what your biggest fear is. So what is your biggest fear and how will you overcome it? Okay, so I want you to share off of the 5 strategies, or if you have another strategy that you've used that supported you in getting over your fear, share it as well. I want to hear like what has worked for you. And one final thing is if you want a customized plan on how you can get out of your own way and overcome fear, then I'm taking actually 3 people that are committed to overcoming their fear, and I will connect with you this week. So if you're one of those 3, put in the comments hashtag freedom, because on the other side of fear is freedom. Put hashtag freedom and I will connect with you. Okay? So with that said, thank you for tuning in. Love you guys. And I will see you next week on Warrior Wednesday. Same time, same station. And sayonara!